Thanks to the magic of television, blockbuster drugs have a way of becoming household names.
Humira.
Advair. Ambien CR.
Viagra single packs.
But why are those names so often absurd? Here's a look at the whole process of drug naming. Pharma companies take the whole naming thing pretty seriously. It takes about 10 years and hundreds of millions of dollars to actually get a drug approved. So by the time it comes to naming it, it's not unlike christening a baby, albeit a weirdly old and expensive baby. Sometimes drug companies will do the brainstorming internally, but most often they contract it out to outside creative agencies.
I was driving around last night in my $62,000 car, and I'm trying to think up a name for the drug, and suddenly it hit me.
And these outside agencies will scour the earth for anything resembling inspiration. Stacks of thesauri, dictionaries of obscure slang, dusty volumes of unused words from yesteryear. Sometimes you want to communicate something about the essence of what a drug is supposed to do. So Viagra, for example, has a tidy etymology. It suggests vigor and vitality and also grow, which one could assume are positive attributes for an erectile dysfunction drug. Emergency contraceptives have friendly names like Ella or Aubra, while diabetes drugs get inspirational names like Invocana and Januvia. And then sleep drugs have soothing names like Ambien and Belsomra. Or take Lunesta, which is pretty easy to break down. Lunar plus restorative, and thus, you're sleepy. A thing that's in vogue now is the space-age sheen of using names that start with the letter X. You've got Xanax, Xeljance, Xiidra, and then of course Cefaxin, which brought us the cuddly bowel known as Gut Guy. The idea might be that giving your drug a name that kind of sounds like a ray gun will gesture toward the future, which is a happier future where the disease you suffer from doesn't exist anymore, or at least isn't as painful. Whether you go literal or name your drug after a Star Wars character,
ask your doctor about twice daily Han Solo.
The FDA rejects about one-third of drug names, and that's often because the new drug sounds too similar to one that already exists. And that can create a legitimate danger if a pharmacist gets confused and a patient who needs a cancer drug instead gets one for erectile dysfunction. The FDA also rejects drug names if they go too far in the direction of promotion. So the agency is fine with those multisyllabic X words, but it stops short of things that suggest just how well a drug works. For example, cancer be gone or erectomatic are no-goes. I've never found a study that established a correlation between the name of a drug and how successful it actually was on the market. And when you look at things, it all seems pretty random. For example, Xiidra, which to me sounds like a reliable hybrid vehicle, was a complete commercial disaster, while as we speak, Eli Lilly is making billions of dollars on a drug called Taltz.
Taltz. Taltz is proven to be...